So good morning children. In the last class we have discussed about addition of 3-digit and 4-digit numbers as well, that is with group regrouping and without regrouping, right? So today we are moving on to the next topic of our second chapter. Okay, so that is properties of addition. So the first property of addition is order property of addition. Order property. So order property is, if we are considering two numbers, that is 5 plus 2. What is 5 plus 2? 5 in mind, 2 in fingers. What is 5 plus 2? It is 7, right? And what about 2 plus 5? What is 2 plus 5? It is again a 7, right? So when we are adding two elements in any of the ways, that is in any order, we will get the same answer. Okay children, while we are adding two elements in any order, we will be getting the same answer. So this is same as in the case of 3-digit and 4-digit numbers as well. So consider this. So what will be the answer here? 3 plus 7 is 10. So we will be writing the 0 here and we will be carry forwarding the 1 to the next place value. And again 1 plus 9 plus 1. 1 plus 9 is 10 and 10 plus 1 is 11. So we will be writing this 1 here and the other 1 in the next place value. Okay, then what is the answer here? 1 plus 8 plus 9. So 1 plus 8 is 9 and 9 plus 9 is 9 in mind, 9 in fingers. Yes, the answer is 18. So we will be writing this 8 here and we will be carrying forward this 1 to the next place value. Okay, so here we are having again 3 numbers. 1 plus 2 plus 2. 1 plus 2 is 3 and 3 plus 2 is 5. So the answer is 5, 8, 1, 10. Okay, now what happens when we rearrange these numbers, when we change the order of these numbers? That is, take your textbook, take page number 32. You can see there, if the order of these two elements, that is if we are adding 2917 to 2893, that is if we have changed the order of the elements, the answer will be the same itself. So that is the order property of addition. Clear children? Even though if we have changed the order of the elements, the sum remains the same. Okay? Now, what about the second property? The second property is grouping property. Second property is grouping property. It is a way similar to order property. That is, if we are having three elements, for example, 3 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, if we are having three elements, 3 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, so we can group these elements in many ways. Okay, first we can add 3 and 2, the answer is 5, and then we can add this answer 5 to this one. So we will get an answer 6. Okay, now if we add 3 and 1 first, if we add 3 and 1 first, we get an answer 4, and we can add this 4 to the remaining 2. Again the answer is 6. Okay children, so even though we change the grouping of the elements, we get the same sum. Even though if we change the grouping of the elements, we get the same sum. Okay, so in your textbook, in page number, in the same page, that is page number 32, you are having an example over there. They are given 3 numbers, 3-digit numbers. So first what we'll do, first we'll add these two numbers. is given here. 456 plus 378 gives 834. Okay, you can see this in the 33rd page of your textbook. So the answer is 834. And then we will be adding this 834 to the remaining add-in, that is 175. And you will be getting the answer 1009. You will be getting the answer 1009. And have a look at the next one, that is, they are added 456 with 175 first, right? 456 with 175 first, and they got answer 631. And they are added the 631 with the remaining added, that is 378. Okay, so they first, they have given three numbers, so they started grouping this one. So they first grouped these two numbers and they got the sum, and then they added this sum to the remaining added and got the sum as 1009. The final answer is 1009. And again, if the grouping changes, that is, if we are adding 378 plus 175, we'll get an answer, and the sum added to 456 again will give the same final answer. Okay, children, so as I already told, even if the grouping of the addends changes, the sum remains the same. Okay, it is quite similar to the order problem. Okay, so moving on to our third property. The third and fourth property is addition of 0 and addition of 1. So addition of 0 is nothing. A 0 added to any number will give the same answer. Okay? The 0 added to any number will give the same number as the answer. For example, 3 plus 0 gives 3 itself. 2819 plus 0 gives 2819 itself. Okay? So 301 plus 0 gives 301 itself. Right, children? So this is what we call addition of 0 property. Then what about addition of 1? Yes, in the last chapter we have learned about successive, right? So that is the similar concept. Addition of 1. Addition of 1 means what? If we are adding 1 to the number, we will get the successor of the given number. If we are adding 1 to 4, that is 4 plus 1 gives 5. 5 is the successor of 4. And what about the other one? 356 plus 1 gives 357. Okay? So 356 plus 1 gives the successor of the given number. Okay? So that is the addition of 1 property. Okay? So that's all about the properties of addition. So we have learned 4 different properties: order property, grouping property, addition of 0, and addition of 1. Okay, children? Now, the next topic in our chapter is estimation of sum. So estimation of sum is quite a similar concept based on the previous chapters, rounding of numbers. Right? You have already learned rounding of numbers, and this is going to be very easy for you people. Okay? So estimation of sum is nothing but we will be having two addends. Okay? We will be having two addends. For example, 8494, okay, and 439 are the two addends. So estimation or estimating the sum means we will be rounding off the addends to nearest tens or nearest hundreds. Okay, that is according to the question. So we will be rounding this addends to nearest tens or nearest hundreds, and then we will get the sum. Okay, so we will not directly add these two given addends in estimating the sum. First, we will be estimating this, or we will be rounding off these two addends difference, and then we will get a set of two new numbers, and we will add those two new atoms to get the answer. Okay, am I clear? So here we are going to add, or we are going to estimate the sum of these two numbers to the nearest tens. So first, what we have to do is we have to round these two atoms to nearest tens. So as you already know, rounding of numbers. To rounding of a number to nearest tens, you have to check the number in ones place. Okay. So here it is 4. 4 is less than 5. So we will be rounding off the number to the same tens value. That is 8490 plus. What about this? Here we have a 9 in the ones place. So 9 is obviously greater than 5. So we will be rounding off this number to the next tens value. That is, here we have 439. So we will be rounding off this number to 440. Yes, 440. And then we will find the answer. Then what will be the answer? 0, 9 plus 4. 9 in mind, 4 in fingers. The answer is? Yes, 13. So we will write 3 here. And we will write the 1 in the next place value. So 1 plus 4 is 5. And 5 plus 4 is 9. And here we have only 8. Here we have nothing. Okay. So 8 plus nothing gives 8 itself. So the answer is 8930. So this is the way you estimate the sum of given two atoms. So what if the question is to estimate the sum of these two numbers to the nearest hundreds? What you will do? Yes, you will be rounding off this number to nearest hundreds, and then you will get a set of new values, and then you will add those two new atoms to get the answer. Okay, children. So here you are having an exercise, exercise number 2.5. So everyone try to do the exercise 2.5, and we will be discussing the answers in the interactive session. Okay. And now, moving on to the next session and the last session of our chapter, that is addition in real life. This is nothing but, you have already heard about story sums, right? Story sums, you have been learning story sums from the lower classes itself. So, in story sums, a question will be given and you have to answer the question in a step-by-step manner. So, everyone take your textbook and take page number 35. So there they have given example 11. Okay, have a look at the example 11. 4,751 cell phones were made in a factory in March, and 3,472 cell phones were made in April. So the question is, how many phones were made altogether in March and April? So the question is, how many total cell phones were made? So we have to answer this question in a step-by-step manner. Right, children? So for that, first we have to read the question carefully. So the first point in the question is 4,751 cell phones were made in March. Right? So the first step will be what? Number of phones or cell phones made in March. So what is the number? It is 4,751. So that's the first step. And what is the next point given in the question? 3,472 cell phones were made in April. So number of cell phones made in April is what? 3,472. And what will be the last step of this answer? Yes, the total number of phones. Is what? How will you find that? We will add these two numbers, right? We will add these two numbers that is given in the question. Okay, children? And we will get the answer as this. Okay? So that is about story sums. So what you have to remember in story sums concept is, you have to read the question carefully and you have to write the answer in a step-by-step manner. That is actually minimum 3 steps. Okay? So you have to read the question carefully, and from the question itself you have to form the steps of the answer. And then finally you have to add the given numbers to get the total sum. Okay, so that's all about this chapter. So in this chapter, we have learned addition in detail, addition of 3-digit, 4-digit numbers, the properties of addition, estimating the sum, and the story sums. So in your textbooks, you people are having 10 story sums, and I will be giving you the answers in your notebook as well. So for today, what you have to do is, you have to complete exercise 2.4 and 2.5 based on today's topic. And the rest story sums, I will be giving you in notes. And we will be discussing the answers of the exercises in the interactive session as well. Okay, so thank you.